Hello and welcome to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. In this video, we are going to understand about electropneumatic trainer kit with PLC and fixed components. So this is a trainer kit. Order code for this trainer kit is 52107. So this is a trainer kit which gives brief description about the electropneumatic products which are now being used from the late centuries in the industrial purposes. Now we move on to the description of different components which are provided with this kit. So this is the double acting cylinder, and also there are two magnetic switch mounted to operations. This is the ore and slide valves. This is also a double acting cylinder without the strut frame, and this is the single acting cylinder with spring return. These are the flow control valves for all the cylinders. This is the 5x2 solenoid valve with double coil solenoid valve. These are the two coils which will be operated with this. This is also a 5x2 double coil solenoid valve. This is the 5x2 single coil solenoid valve, and this is the 3x2 single coil solenoid valve. This is the manifold which will be used to give the input from different lines, and this is the slide valve which start and stop the main incoming line with this kit. So now move on to PLC section. This is a PLC of 12 inputs, 8 outputs. The junction of input and outputs are also provided terminals with this kit. These are the junction box and 3 NO switches and 1 selector type on and off switch. Also there is 24 volt power supply to give supply to different coils and PLC as well. Now we move on to the different accessories which are provided with this kit. So these are some patch cords to connecting the connections, and these are ready to use double pin banana connector keys which can be easily installed to all the connectors and the solenoid coils. This is also a PU tube of 4 mm, about 15 meter PU tube we are providing to use in the different experiments. These are some stoppers and some PU fittings and PU T lines to use the experiment, which we are also providing the software CD to install the software which are used to working with the PLC. We are also providing interface cable. Right now it is the LAN cable we are using here to program the PLC. And this is the FRL unit, filter, lubrication and regulator unit. So this unit is the main connected with the main incoming supply of the air compressor, and this also have a pressure gauge to give the pressure. This will show the actual pressure which is of the air compressor. So now we will move on to the different exercises. We will now perform the different exercises with these different components of pneumatic, and also we do the controlling of these pneumatic products with the PLC. So first we will connect the compressor incoming line to the FRL unit. So this is the incoming line. This should be connected here. There is also an arrow which shows the flow of incoming lines. So now after connecting the incoming line to the FRL unit, make sure always the stopper are connected while we do not connected the outgoing of this FRL unit to the any of the product in the pneumatic workbench. So now I will on the pressure, and the pressure will be shown at the pressure gauge. So you can see the pressure is about 3 bars. You can also regulate the pressure higher and lower with this regulator valve like this. So required pressure can be set with this regulator valve. Now for further experiment, we will connect this one of this output of this FRL unit to this manifold, and we will perform rest of the experiments for this. So as you can see, I have removed one of the stopper from this FRL unit's output, and we will connect PU tube from this output to the manifold input. At this time I have shut off the valve that of compressor, so that right now the pressure is zero. Now we will perform the first exercise to operate a single acting cylinder with a 5x2 solenoid valve. For this we use this manifold and we will use one of a point from this manifold. As I input this valve, as I connected this PU tube to this input, the outcoming will started automatically when I connect any of the point from this manifold. So this is the slide valve which need to be in the upward direction always to close, and this will be the open section of this valve. So now while we doing the pneumatic connections, the valve should be in closed position. We will give this input to the 5x2 valve. So this is the input of the 5x2 valve, spring return single coil 5x2 valve, solenoid valve. Now we will connect one terminal of this to the flow control valve, and other end of this flow control valve will be connected to the single solenoid valve. So there is, you notice that one of the output of a 5x2 solenoid valve is right now open. So we don't require this output, so we will close this output with this stopper and we will perform the electrical connections after programming the PLC, and we will control this single solenoid valve with this. So we now move on to the programming section. So after doing the pneumatic connections, we will now require PLC to be programmed. So first we have to give the supply to power on the PLC. For this we connect this 24 volt power supply, positive and negative, to this 24 volt junction box, and in continuation we will connect positive to this positive of the PLC junction, and negative will be connected to this negative. Now to giving the supply properly to this junction, we will short these points, both the red points and both the negative points, and we will power on this supply. So here you can see the PLC is now power on. Now we will use the LAN cable to communicate this PLC with our PC. For this we will connect this LAN cable at this LAN port, and our PLC is now connected. Here you can see the LAN blinking, the LAN LED is now blinking. So PLC is now connected to the LAN cable. Now we will program to operate this single acting cylinder with this PLC software. So now after doing the pneumatic connections, now we will do the programming. Connecting the PLC is the typical process. You can also have or need some guidance while performing. So while we connect, after connecting the PLC, now we will do the programming with this software. The software is also provided with this CD. So this is our software. Here we can program and do the different programmings. So I have already made up this program for controlling of single cycle of a single acting cylinder. So this is the program, and now we download this program to our PLC. So this is our PLC IP address. We will test the link. The link is correct. Now we will download this program to the PLC and now we will start the simulation to verify our program while working. So now we will do the electrical connections. So our electro-pneumatic process will be complete. So for this we will need a patch codes. Now we will give input to the input 1 and also provide the input to the 13 number point. So when we press this button, the 24 volt power supply will be going to the I1 input. Now we will connect this magnetic sensor. For this we will use this specially designed 3-point patch codes banana cable. So one end of this cable will be connected to the connector of this magnetic sensor. This magnetic sensor needs power supply, so power supply will be provided to positive from this brown wire and negative will be connected to this blue wire, and that's output will be connected to the I2, which is the A0 magnetic sensor we have defined. So right now you can see at this sensor the yellow LED is glowing. That means the sensor is in operating position, because the piston of the cylinder is on the backwards position. That's why the sensor showing that its output is giving. Now we will connect the other sensor similarly with these cables, which is the A1 sensor which we have defined in the program. So positive goes to the positive and blue wire goes to the negative, and this black output will be at I3. So I3 is the A2 sensor which we have defined. Now we will also need a red and black banana connector to power on the coil of this solenoid valve. For this we will connect this connector to the coil like this, and black wire of this patch cord will be connected to negative and positive of this coil will be connected to Q1. So that's the output which is giving with the PLC. Now we will on the slide valve from here and give the input and we will observe the one cycle of the single acting cylinder like this. As the cylinder reaches to the forward position, the magnetic sensor of this forward position will be operate and give the signal to going backward to the cylinder. So forward and reverse movement from one input we can observe here. So this is the single acting cylinder cycle with PLC controlled electro-pneumatic workbench. Now we will perform the next experiment, which is the multi-cycle operation of a double acting cylinder. For this we will do the pneumatic connections. For this we will connect this manifold's output to a 5x2 double coil solenoid valve. In this we will use the double coil solenoid valve and we will give the output to the flow control valve. I will also explain the working of a flow control valve in this experiment and other output of this flow control valve will be flow control valve for the forward section and for the reverse section as well. And we will connect this cylinder like this. So these are the basic pneumatic connection which we have done. Now we will move on to the PLC programming and the electrical connections. So this is the program of multi-cycle operation of a double acting cylinder. So I have already made up this program. Now we will download this program to the PLC. The program has been downloaded and we will start the online test simulation. Now we will do the electrical connections for the operation of this exercise. So for this we will give input from this input PV to input 1, and we will also provide 24 volt to this 13 number terminal. So the 20, when we press this button, the 24 volt will be provided to input 1. Now we will also need an stop push button. For this we will connect positive to the 13 number pin of this NC button, and we will require a line patch code to giving the input at the second input, input 2, I2. And now we will connect the magnetic sensors. For this we will require the 3-point cable, and we will connect this cable to this magnetic sensor like this, and we will provide positive to the brown, negative to the blue, and output will be provided to input 3 for A0 sensor. This is the A0 sensor. We will again connect the A1 sensor, magnetic sensor, through this cable, and will give positive and negative as well, similarly as A0, and will give to I4 like this. Now we will connect the solenoid coils for the output. So we will require 2-point cable, and we will connect this solenoid coil, which is the Q1, the S1 solenoid coil, the S2 solenoid coil. So S1 will be connected to output Q1. For this we will give negative here, and this will be connected to the Q1, and we will require another 2-point cable to the other solenoid coil, and also we will provide negative and give this to the Q2. So our electrical connections has been done. So before performing the exercise, once verify the connections to the accurate output results. So after verifying all the electrical connections and the pneumatic connections, now we will start and give this input to the multi-cycle of this double acting cylinder. So as I press the input, so sometimes you need to align this magnetic sensor that was not aligned in earlier. So as I align this magnetic sensor, now you can see the yellow light is blinking. That means the sensor is giving output. Now we will start the cycle. So you can see the multi-cycle operation of this double acting cylinder is going on. As we want to stop this cycle, so we will press this stop button and the cycle stops. So this is the double acting cylinder. I will also explain the flow control valve similarly in this cycle. So as I start this cycle again, you can see right now the speed is very low of forward and reverse movement. So as I open this flow control valve, you can observe that the forward movement of this cycle is increased. Similarly, we will also increase the other end. So now we will start the cycle. As I press the input, you can observe the multi-cycle operation of a double acting cylinder. So in this we are using flow control valve. So I will explain the working of this flow control valve. You can observe the speed and you can control the flow of air to controlling the speed of forward and backward movements of this double acting cylinder like this. As I close this valve, the speed decreases when the flow decreases. You can observe the speed is decreasing. So this is the minimum speed of this cylinder. You can see I have controlled this speed by using flow control valve. So that's the operation of flow control valve with a PLC control double acting cycle of multi-cycle operation of a double acting cylinder. So we can increase the flow with this and control the flow with this flow control valve. For stopping this cycle, we will press this stop button once and you can see the cycle has been stopped. So if we again start this cycle by pressing this, the cycle started and the cycle stopped when we press the stop button. So that's how we use the double acting cylinder multi-cycle operation. So now as the last experiment and the biggest experiment on this kit will be the performing of sequencing of A plus, B plus, C plus, C minus, B minus, A minus. These are the positions of the cylinder. So as one cylinder moves forward, which will be the plus of this cylinder, which is the forward movement, and when the cylinder goes reverse, this is the minus movement. So we will use the A, B and C cylinder and we will perform the sequencing A plus, B plus, C plus, then C minus, A minus, B minus, sorry, C minus, B minus and A minus. So for this we will use two double coil solenoid valve and one single coil 5x2 solenoid valve. Now we will do the pneumatic connections. For this we will connect one solenoid valve input, also we will connect the solenoid valves input to this manifold and the third solenoid valve to this input. Now we will directly connect the cylinders from these valves. Always make sure that the left end will be connected to the back end of this cylinder and right end will be connected to the right end of this cylinder. So similarly in the both double acting cylinder we will do the same connections. The left end output will be connected to the back end and right end output will be connected to the front end. And we required one more PU tube to connect the single acting cylinder. So these are our pneumatic connections that has been done for the sequencing operation. Now we will do the electrical connections. So in the PLC program, this is the program for sequence logic of A plus, B plus, C plus, C minus, B minus, A minus. So the program has been already made up. This is the lengthy program. So we have made up all the programs before doing the demonstration and experiments. So we will download this program to our PLC. So the program has been downloaded and we will start the simulation and we will do the electrical connections now. For this, I have already connected all the sensor cables and coil cables. So just we need lesser time to give the inputs. So we will give the first start PV input from this start button to input 1. We will provide 24 volt to the 13 number pin. We also required stop or the selector, start selector switch. So this will be connected to the input 2 in the PLC and we will provide 24 volt to this section as well. Now we will connect the different sensors and coils. So for input, we will start with this A cylinder. So these are the A0, A1 sensors, these are the B0, B1 sensor and these are the C0 and C1 sensor. So first we will connect the A0 sensor. So positive will be brown and negative will be ground and this will be connected to the I3 input as we defined in the program. Now we will connect the A1 similarly, positive, negative and this will be going to I4. Now we will connect B0 sensor as an input. So this is the positive, negative and output will be going to I5. Now we will connect B1 positive, negative and output will be I6. So now we will connect C0 sensor, positive to positive, negative to negative and this will be going to I7 and also the last input, positive, negative and this will be going to I8. So these are the input connections. Now we will connect the output coils. There are now 5 coils, so all will be connected to the output terminals. So first we will connect the S1 solenoid coil, the negative here and positive will be provided from this output terminal Q1. Now S2 solenoid coil, so this will be negative and will be connected to Q2. Now we will further move on to the S3 coil. So this is the S3 solenoid's negative and positive will be going to the Q3 and further S4
So this is the negative and output will be Q4. And last coil, which is S5 solenoid coil, so negative at here, and this will be going to Q5. So our electrical connections now has been done. We will verify these connections and do the experiment. So after verifying all the connections, pneumatic as well as electrical connections, we are ready to perform the multi-cycle or sequence operation. So for this, we first start this selector. So you can see the sequencing operation of A plus, B plus, then A minus, then C minus. So there are two inputs. For single cycle, we will press this button one time, and for continuing cycle, we will press this selector switch. So first we will do the single cycle. So this is the single cycle of A plus, B plus, C plus, then C minus, B minus, A minus. A plus, B plus, C plus, C minus, A, B minus, A minus. For continue cycle, we will press the selector switch and the cycle continue goes on till we off the selector or the non-momentary push button. So that's how we perform the sequence cycle of A plus, B plus, C plus, C minus, B minus, A minus. So these are the different combinations which we have derived and performed from the PLC control. So for more details and more programming exercises, you can refer to our manual. And for any details and query about this product, you can contact. For more details and any other queries about this product, or to purchase this product, you can contact to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. Thank you.